Hello everyone and welcome to our Islands of Adventure vlog from September 2022.
Yep.
We are starting our 2020 holiday that was delayed 2 years. We are very excited to be here. Claire, how are you feeling?
Excited, a little nervous.
You've not done Holt. We've not done Islands of Adventure, brilliant. We've not done Velocicoaster nor Hagrid's, which are two of the main rides that we're really looking forward to. Let's get in the park and see what's going on. We're just so buzzing to be here. Let's go. The adventure begins. Yeah, let's grab a map. Big up on the map vibes. Love this. So we have had a look at the ride queue times. Some larger waits here today. There's a Hulk is on at an hour. Hagrid's is on at 75 minutes. As such, we're gonna head for Velocicoaster for our first ever ride, which is apparently 35 minutes, which isn't too bad. So this is the port of entry where there's like, it's like a bit of a like bizarre sort of theme to it and loads of interesting shops, bakery and stuff. So you can see Velocicoaster just off in the distance. That is where we are heading. It looks shiny. Do we want to get express pass?
No.
No, we don't. Well, we do, but we don't want to buy it, so. Oh look, there's Hulk, my favorite coaster in the world. Right, let's go. Oh wow, you can see, oh my god, that's amazing. That is freaking incredible. Jurassic Park looks unreal in the distance there, the way they've done that. Oh, that's amazing. Right, I think we go access it around to the right. Is this a new way into Jurassic Park? Obviously you've got Velocicoaster crossing over the path here twice, or more than twice actually. Sorry? No, not quite, but I think it makes up for it with this coaster here. Wow, that is absolutely immense. Wow. Wow, that entrance is something else. Holy shit. Right, we need to put our items in a locker, so we'll do that and then we'll see you after the ride, I think.
You will be going through metal detection. Make sure.
Wow. Wow. That is absolutely incredible looking. Fucking hell, oh my god, the eyeballs are so good.
Shit.
So much swearing, I'm sorry. Right, here we go, locker time, so we'll see you in a few minutes. Well, we'll see you instantaneously. I think I'm sweating quite a lot, but that ride is absolutely incredible. Absolutely incredible. The combination of elements, here we go. That was terrible direction, so there you go, really, really bad. But yeah, the ride is absolutely incredible. It's nice and long, the launches are snappy. Coming out of the launch into the top hat, when the sun hits you, is an incredible and unique feeling. Some of the inversions are nuts. I don't know what this long stall is, but it is absolutely incredible how long you're kept upside down. A lot of people say it, the inversion, I think it's a heartline roll over the water, is absolutely immense. This top hat is sick. Yeah, we were on the second train, front row of the second train, so we got a little bit of hang time on the top hat. And the theming is incredible. The queue's really good. The queue moves so fast. Pre-shows are really good. Claire, how did you find it?
So sweaty. Yeah, it was fantastic. Don't bring a massive backpack.
Oh yeah, don't bring a massive backpack. Yeah, we struggled with the lockers, didn't we?
Yeah, so the lockers are tiny. So if you do have a big backpack, you'll have to find a big locker somewhere.
Yeah, they only have like small sort of letterbox. Well, we did manage it. We took the stuff out of the backpack, didn't we?
Yeah.
But yeah, it's boiling now. Yeah, we're gonna go look at some merch now, guys. It is swelteringly hot. But that gives it a nice Jurassic Park sort of vibe. Wow, what a ride though, oh my god. Certainly one of the best in the world. It's in my top five. I need to think about it and get some more rides on it before definitively placing it exactly where it is. Huh? Oh, the lock. Oh, there are. Oh, the big.
You can bring a big bag.
Yeah, do bring a big bag, but get the lockers in here. Yeah, that's much better, isn't it? But it transfers through the park all day, doesn't it? Yeah, that's right. And it transfers through the park, doesn't it? All day.
You will need your park.
Yeah, cool. Right, let's look at the merchandise. Ooh, there's nice little dinosaurs in here. The nice big dinosaurs as well. Look at them. Wow. Oi. Yeah, this is a nice t-shirt to be fair. I don't normally go for the light ones, but I do like that. Might need to grab that later.
Yeah.
Thinking that might be a purchase. Oh, this is nice. Nice print. Oh, yeah, that's really nice. We're playing an in-gen game now. Look, we've got the DNA character from Jurassic Park.
Look to the screen below. Imagine you're already a dinosaur and tell me, are you a carnivore or are you fast or strong?
Oh.
Are you large? And finally, are you good? With this information, we can have two. Your brain scan.
Brain scan, okay.
Good going.
Wow, I think I'm going to be a T-Rex.
So, turn to your right, place your right hand on the blue handrest.
Oh dear, it sprayed me. Wow. 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 What the hell? Oh my god, what the hell has happened? Why did they do that? I feel bad now. Nah. No. Players just put an egg into the chamber, a physical egg from there, and you know what you're doing? You're scanning it to see if there's a dinosaur in there. Wow, this promotional artwork for Velocicoaster looks awesome. I love that. Oh, brilliant. Pathetic. Walking upstairs trying to film. Absolute moron. Nearly fell over. Anyway, yeah. Not even in focus. Pathetic video. Yeah, so I'd like to apologise for this being a terrible vlog so far. We have just found Lego though, so we'll definitely have a look at this.
Ooh.
This is a really nice 4 Plus set, actually. Very nice. Oh, this is old.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm surprised they got this. This is very old. I wonder how much that is. Where's the price? I'm pretty sure it's retired. Right, we're thinking we're now going to go to Harry Potter and the Forbidden Journey. Because looking at the... You find it a bit sick making, don't you?
A bit icky, yeah.
Yeah, Forbidden Journey is on a 15 minute queue apparently, so we're going to give that a go. Right, we're now walking into Hogsmeade. Hogs, brilliant. Pathetic, Hogsmeade. I called it bloody Hogsmeade. This is Blaze's Pizza all over again, for God's sake. Riching myself off now. Oi, butter beer. Yeah, I think we'll grab one of them after the ride. We've just got off of Harry Potter and the Forbidden Journey, and it was just absolutely incredible. I absolutely love that ride. It's so good. It's probably still my favourite dark ride. The transitions between the screens, which are really good motion simulators, and the physical theming, in particular the dragon, is so good. Special effects are amazing, lighting. We actually had a small shutdown, like a breakdown. So there's a Whomping Willow scene, and we were like that with the Whomping Willow, weren't we, Claire?
Yeah, we were like that close to the Whomping Willow.
Did you enjoy the ride?
Yeah, I mean, it is... I am alright on it. I don't really get motion sick, but I can see how people get sick of it. Like, the robot art, sometimes I'm like, oh my god, like, this is...
Yeah, you do fully go, like,
yeah,
entirely
really
on your
like,
back.
Sort of chuck your body, like, your body
yeah.
is moving.
I think you invert in places.
Yeah.
Like,
so if you do get motion sick, it is more useful.
Yeah, like it is an intense ride in terms of what actually happens to your body, but It's just so much fun. Such a good ride.
But we actually got to see, because it did break down, we actually got to see the mechanics of it.
So yeah, yeah, that was really good. We actually broke down in the Wampin Willow scene, so we saw another party. We were probably like that.
Yeah, we were in a
and they were
position, right?
They were completely on their back, so you could sort of see a bit of the behind the scenes and stuff. So that was quite cool. And they're building a similar ride to that at Epic Universe, Universal's new theme park, which is going to be a Universal Monsters ride set in Frankenstein's castle, I think, isn't it? So absolutely cannot wait for that. I can only imagine, you know, that ride is 12 years old and it's still so technologically advanced. I cannot imagine what they're going to do with one that's brand new.
I think I need to correct you on something. You said the lockers, when you pay for a locker, they move around with you. I don't think they do.
The ones over at Jurassic World do. Yeah, the ones that we just used was like a $2 or $3 single use. I don't know why the ones why that one isn't a move around one. But yeah, we're gonna get a butterbeer now. Got our frozen butterbeer, haven't we?
Mm-hmm.
It's absolutely incredible. We bloody love these. We're sharing one. Heading to Honeydukes now. Here we go. Oh. When you're hit by air, when you're hit by air. Nice little cooler bag, that's cute. You guys seen American Pie? Hogwarts Express, we love you. British things and that. Oh God, that drink is so freaking delicious. We think we're going to head off to the Jurassic Park River Adventure now. I had a 45 minute wait earlier, it's down to 25 now, which is not too bad for that. And yeah, apologies guys, we obviously can't take you on the rides at this park. Universal don't allow filming on their rides. Fortunately, they are the minority of this trip. Both Busch Gardens and SeaWorld and Disney let you let you film on rides. You don't see that bloody helicopter in the films, do you? Right, we're now walking the correct way. Oh my God. We're now walking the correct way into Jurassic Park. Wow, madness. Here is the Spinosaurus from Jurassic Park 3, along with the original Jeeps, which I believe were used in the films. That actual prop, correct me if I'm wrong, commenters, but I think that is a hashtag trivia fact. More hashtag trivia facts to come. Nah, it's lame. Delete that. That's the Raptor encounter where you can meet Blue the Raptor. Oh wow, look at this view of Velocicoaster. Wow, this is awesome. I mean, just look at all of this track, all of this mess of track, the theming around here. Oh my God, just incredible. Wow. River Adventure, we don't know how long the queue is for this. Oi, big up. Wow, 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 wow. Yeah, 25, we'll give that a go. Yeah, we did get a bit wet on Jurassic River Adventure. Yes, a little bit moist. I'm now rocking the two-tone. Yeah, you got a couple of tones on your grey there now, ain't you? But yeah, bloody, yeah, nice and refreshing. Like, yeah, immediate, like not even sort of cold or anything, obviously. Just, yeah, a refreshing spray. Slightly not broken in places, but there's a few effects that are not functional, well, broken, I suppose, like the gates being closed. I wouldn't ever actually like to see it be rethemed to be Jurassic World like they've done at Universal Studios California. But hang on, what we got here? Go on, here we go. Rah. Yeah, I wouldn't like to see it rethemed to Jurassic World, would you, Claire? But I think it could do with some new theming, yeah. Just Jurassic Park, freshen it up a bit. It's still a brilliant ride though, still a brilliant water ride. And one of those iconic attractions. Very high capacity as well. I think we probably waited 10 to 15 rather than 25. Certainly wasn't anywhere near 25. So yeah, we're doing well today, very happy. We're now in a section of the park called Camp Cretaceous, which is like a little children's play area sort of section themed to Jurassic Park. So it's got these big dinosaur legs and stuff. No, we've never done this bit because we're not children. Yeah, just a walkthrough. I think it's aimed at children though, isn't it? Oh look, there's pterodon flyers there. Now to ride that, you actually need to have a child with you. So unless you want to kidnap anyone, we're not getting on it, I'm afraid.
Want to walk on it?
Yeah, do you want to go up there? Here we go, this should be a laugh. Oh yeah, this is alright. Need to, oh god. Oh, don't fall over and get rope burn, Claire. It might be easier with two hands. Oh god. Bloody workout that is. Wow, mental. Here we go. Oh my god, this is a crouchy one. Oh god, I don't want to drop my camera down there. Actually, I'm going to put my camera away. Oh god. Right, here we go. This is like dodgy as. Something smells absolutely incredible near here though. I don't know what it is. God, this is like sprained ankle area. You could really get a sprained ankle if you're not careful on that bit. What the hell is this? Oh God, you got to, no, we're not doing that. We've got to go back. Oh good god. Oh this is cool, we just entered a little underground bit where we can see bits of amber. You found a bug? Ew. I wonder if they're real. Ew. Oh wow, I love the butter vision. I love the lighting and the ambience in here. It smells a bit smoky in here as well, doesn't it, Claire? I don't know if they pump smoke in, or if, yeah, musty. It might just be musty from being old. Don't know if they pump actual sort of scents into it. But yeah, oh, that was lovely in there. Ooh, yeah, that's a fun little area to be fair, actually, isn't it? Yeah, very nice.
We're lost.
Yeah, we're lost now. We found something else, actually. It's not over yet, guys. Ooh, I like the colours. Whoa. We found a cave. Oh wow, this is awesome. It smells really good in here. Swimming pool-y clean. Oh, this is very atmospheric though. Exit. I love the lighting in here. Oh wow, we're going over the top of a water thing. Definitely don't want to drop my camera here then. Oh wow, I love this section. All the lights give it so much atmosphere. Oh, wow. Oh, don't miss this. This is lovely. Be nice if they had a dinosaur here. Oh wow, look at that, Claire. All the different colours. It reminds me of underneath Magic Kingdom. Wow. Under the castle, huh?
You mean Disneyland Paris?
Sorry?
You mean Disneyland Paris?
Oh, is it Paris? Oh, sorry. Yeah, because there's a dragon, isn't there? Yeah, they need to stick, like, I think if they put a big, just dinosaur face in here or something, I think it'd get a bit more, be a bit more popular, wouldn't it? Because I feel like people don't really know about this. I don't think I've ever really seen this on any vlogs. Maybe I haven't forgot it, but, oh my god, this is so sort of magical feeling, isn't it, Claire? I'm glad we found this.
Wow. Amazing. I think we found the exit here, obviously. Ooh. Oh, she's off. She's off again. Is there more? Blimey, this wraps around a lot, doesn't it?
Oh, right.
Oh, this is the exit to Pterodon Flyers. Yeah, maybe. Interesting. Yeah, cool. We are absolute explorers, those guys, so yeah, don't worry about it. Oh my god. Awesome little area. Okay, I think the plan now is to head to Marvel Superhero Island. For quite a lot of the days that have happened in recent periods of time and like scheduled coming up, including today, there's a lot of like rainfall and thunderstorms in Florida. So from 2, I haven't checked recently actually, but from 2 it's probably going to be rainy here. So we probably want to try and get stormy. So we probably want to try and get Hulk done before then. And then we can do the indoor things like Skull Island, Reign of Kong, which is right next to us here, and Spider-Man and stuff. So that's our rough plan. But we'll see how it pans out. Right, we're now walking through Toon Lagoon with this epic, iconic bridge and this epic view here of Dudley Do-Right's Ripsaw Falls. Look at that. How's that for iconic views, eh? Here we go. We are entering Marvel Superhero Island, one of the most awesome and epic theme park areas ever. Iceman there. Namor. Spider-Man? Yeah. Let's just do Hulk, just whilst it's nice weather, I'd say. Because we can do Spider-Man if it starts to storm. Oh wow, this is a cool looking shop. Nice aircon in here. Ooh, I really like the merch they got in here. Oh, Christ, hello. Is this a woman's one? That's obviously for a woman. Claire, you should buy it, that's sick. You should buy it, Claire. Buy it. Fuck. Oh my god, look at all these. Oh my god. Wow. Updates. We've actually been on a few rides since we last filmed any footage. We went on Hulk, Claire's first ride on Hulk. It was formerly my favourite roller coaster, however, having ridden it now, I still absolutely love it. Completely missed that. Embarrassingly missed that. Yeah, I still absolutely love it. God. Just like the worst vlogger in the world. Yeah, still absolutely love it. And this giant cobra roll and giant loop, I do think are absolutely incredible elements. They're slightly rough with a little bit of headbanging, like God, B&M, Get on the lap bar restraints, boys. This is, you know, we have entered a new age. Keep with the times. And I just absolutely love the theming. I still absolutely love it, but it's probably not my top coaster anymore. Claire, it was your first ever ride. What did you think?
It was intense, a little head bangy, but it was good.
Yeah. Very fair.
Not
in your top five, no.
I think close my eyes simply because the sun is like in my eyes.
Yeah, we're feeling very hot right now. We think we've never done Dr. Doom's Fearful, so we're gonna give it a go. We think never done it, so let's give it a bash. I assume you just leave your bags at the bottom on this. Yeah, it's like the fourth time we've been here and we've never done this. So yeah, let's give it a go. There's a Doom bot there, nice. Let's go. Oh my god, I love this pattern on the walls. Oh my god, the aircon in here is an absolute godsend. Latveria Embassy. Oh my god, I love this theming. This is awesome. Oh wow. Ooh, I love this queue. This is sick. I've got to imagine waiting this long for it though. It's only the two shot towers. Oh, this is sick. I'm well into this. Best queue for a drop tower I've ever seen.
Why is that cold in here?
Yeah, just stay in here. It's freezing here. It's lovely. Ooh. Oh wow, this is sick. This queue is so good. This is an opening day attraction as well, 23 years old. Oh, bollocks. Oh well, there we go, that was Dr. Doom's Fearful. Oh, well, I bloody love that. The queue is brilliant. Theming's really good. The way that the ride actually operates is brilliant. It's obviously got two towers and you're split up into various groups. Yeah, so you're split up into various groups, and so there's like four doors on each tower, and then each group is obviously put at one of the doors, and the doors are like faces of Dr. Doom, which then open, they're plane doors as you're queuing, and then the other side, when you're sitting in the ride, you're looking at Dr. Doom's face. Love the theming. And then the ride, really good, just a really good shop tower with epic views of Florida. Yeah, I thought it was great. Claire, that was your first ever shop tower, wasn't it?
No, we just had this conversation.
Proper one though. You've done, was it Mystic Tower? Mystic Tower at Fantasia Land. And yeah, you liked it, right?
Yeah, it was good, yeah, it was fun.
Did you like the view? You pointed out fun spot, didn't you?
Yeah, I saw fun spot, but that was about it.
Yeah. To be honest, we were actually facing the wrong side, really. I mean, it was good to see fun spot, but you want to be facing the other side so you see Islands of Adventure rather than the wider... We're keeping an eye out for little ones.
Little cuddly toys.
Yeah. This is like a games arcade. I'm liking this, to be fair. They've really good choice of games in here. Pretty awesome. And it's air-conned. Right, slightly annoying, guys, because there's actually just too many really good t-shirts in the Marvel shops at Islands of Adventure. Oh, this would have been good. This is the Spider-Man shop. Yeah. I had gathered that, to be fair. But no, that's fine. Spider-Man literally walked out of this shop. Spider-Man walked out of this shop and we said hello to him. It was a shame I wasn't filming, actually, but yeah, selection of youth shirts and some Spider-Man climbies. Oh my god, mate, they just, honestly, there's endless merchandisers here. Oh, is this the exit to the Spider-Man ride? Okay,
Interesting. Yeah, this is a brilliant shop. The shops here, the Marvel shops here are amazing, Claire. Oh, absolutely loving it. So we've now got a stuffed pretzel and a bloody overflowing icy. And we're going to eat this in Marvel Superhero Island. Oh, it's hot down there, is it? Oh my God, storm. Storm and Rogue are out. Needs a bit of beer dipping sauce, that does. Lovely though. Very nice. Nice and salty. Nice pizza vibe from it. Stuffed with pepperoni and tomato-y cheese stuff, innit? Nice. There's a turtle down here. Turtle just swimming around in the theme park. What's he doing? Oh wait, there's two. There's two now. Aww. Look, they're just in this little pondy bit. It's Storm and Rogue! Yay! Okay, I don't know what they're doing here. If anyone knows, let me know in the comments. I don't know what's going on here. It's obviously not a ride, even though I would love them to build more rides in this area. Wow, it's Wolverine. You can't... He's not chosen the best background. But yeah, there he is, Wolverine, Logan, James Howlett. Love it. Right, we're going to go on Spider-Man now. The desks of all the Daily Bugle workers with Easter eggs on. Spider-Man villains and whatnot. Oh, I love this ride. So, Spider-Man comic. It is, you know, this is a brilliant ride. And the one that they've created in Disneyland Paris and Disneyland California, they look so poor in comparison. It's a real shame. Anyway, hashtag be positive. Yeah, let's concentrate on where we are and that I absolutely love this ride. Right, we'll catch up with you when we're out. God, that ride is just absolutely incredible. What did you think, Claire?
Yeah, it's very good. Another motion simulator.
Yeah, true. But yeah, it's so well done. I think, Buster Vision. I think they've actually updated the graphics as well since we last rode it. All of the like video in there is perfect, isn't it? They must have updated that. It looks a lot more modern, like the actual video itself. Than the last time we did it. Oh, it's getting very windy here now, isn't it, Claire?
Yeah, storm rolling in.
Yeah, we're going to try and get on Hagrid's, I think, aren't we?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to try and queue for Hagrid's magical creature bike thing. Yeah, storms probably in the area, so we, you know, we might get kicked out of the queue or something like that, mightn't we, Claire? That's what we're sort of concerned of, but we're going to give it a try, see what we can do. Well, at least all the rain makes this scene a bit more movie accurate. I'm not sure you can see the rain much. But it started to get quite wet. And I have just lost my wife, which is interesting. Oh, she's there. Yeah, sorry, momentarily lost her. Yeah, you can probably see the rain now. So for you guys it's been absolutely no time at all, but for us it's been about 2 hours because we got in a queue for Hagrid's when it was sort of raining, which we did sort of know was stupid. Yeah, because we're stupid we decided to join the queue for Hagrid's when it started raining, so we ended up waiting 2 hours because it was basically closed for most of that. But we got on it and it was absolutely incredible. Phenomenal ride. The best family coaster I've ever been on. Boom, I'll throw that out there. So long, so many elements, loads of launches. The spike is super fun. The drop track section is super fun. It's got amazing animatronics. Blew me away. Yeah, better than I expected. Claire,
yeah,
what did you...
Yeah, it's very, very good. Just, yeah.
You rode in the motorcycle,
yeah,
didn't you?
Yeah, I got the motorcycle.
And I did the sidecar.
Yeah, surprising actually. About how good it was.
Yeah. So so many launches.
Yeah, loads of launches. count that many.
Some really nice G there, picked up on some of the wines
yeah,
and like
really quite awesome.
And bends. Yeah, yeah, epic.
Ooh, an All Hallows Eve boutique, a Halloween store. Wow, this is awesome, look at this. Wow, this is something else. Oh, this is awesome. Absolutely awesome. Wow, look at all this stuff. Boutique.
Still a little, it's not raining anymore, but there's a lot of water on the ground. So our feet have been quite wet for quite a long time now. It's about 5 p.m. and we've got a booking at Big Fire at 5:15. So we're actually going to leave the park now. So we'll do a little wrap up in a minute. Brilliant. We'll do a little wrap up in a minute. And yeah, sum up our day at Islands of Adventure.
The iconic shot across the water. Oh God, one of the best views in theme park world.
And when
yeah, Hulk probably is down with the inclement weather affecting. Yeah, your ride is down due to inclement weather, which was thunderstorms in the area. It actually wasn't raining for I think most of the time that we were in the queue. It was just lightning in the area, so dangerous to run rides. Oh, Hulk is going, just missed it.
We've just walked through Seuss Landing, and this is another land. Another visit to Islands of Adventure where we have failed to do any rides in Seuss Landing. We are going to be back here probably a couple times, like probably one evening we're going to come and like mill in a little bit when we're doing a Universal Studios day probably. So we are going to go on them, aren't we? Probably try and get... Yeah, probably going to try and get on Kong as well.
Hey, what's up, y'all?
Yes! Yeah, so big up that guy, bless up yourself, and yeah. Islands of Adventure, Claire. We had a brilliant day, absolutely jam-packed. We got on a couple of new rides, like newish rides. Well, sort of new to us.
Yeah.
But we also did rides that we haven't been before that are old. You know, opening day attraction, Doctor Doom's Fearful. What are your highlights?
Velocicoaster, Hagrid. I think they're my two main ones.
Yeah, Hagrid's and Velocicoaster for me as well. Doctor Doom was a nice surprise. Wasn't expecting a whole lot from it, and I do find drop towers and shot towers slightly scary. Says Margie shitting myself.
Aww.
But no, loved it to be fair. And
now you know how I feel when you drag me on these massive coasters.
Yeah, but.
Not nice, is it?
Well, fine.
No.
Yeah, absolutely brilliant day. It feels like we, even though we stood in a queue for 2 hours at the end, feels like we jam-packed loads in, and I'm really happy that we just didn't really overindulge as well. We had like just the butterbeer and the icy, and then just one pretzel. That's all we've had to eat today. So we're having Big Fire now. We're gonna do a separate video on Food Review UK for our Big Fire review, which is a sort of barbecue restaurant, smoky grilled meat sort of barbecue restaurant at City Walk. So check that out. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you in the next episode.
Bye.
Bye.